This lesson is on the difference quotient of a function, but we'll start with a review. Given f of x equals 2x squared minus x plus 4, find the arc between x equals negative 1 and x equals negative 2. So the arc is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, and we have our x1 and we have our x2, but we don't have our y1 and our y2. So you have to plug these x coordinates into the function to find their y coordinate partner. So we have to do that first. So f of negative 1 is equal to 2 parentheses negative 1 quantity squared minus parentheses negative 1 plus 4. And you can use a calculator, but this would be positive 1, so this would be 2 plus 1 plus 4, which is 7. So we have our y1, ordered paired negative 1, 7. All right, now we need to find f of negative 2, so we'll plug it in. This minus out here belongs to the function. This negative inside the parentheses belongs to the input. So the parentheses are helpful. Again, you can plug that into your calculator. I'll do that one with the calculator so you can see. You can just plug in what you see. 2 parentheses negative 2 close parentheses square minus parentheses, this gray button here for the negative 2 parentheses plus 4. Okay, 14. So that's our y2. So our two order pairs are negative 1, 7 and negative 2, 14. Then we can plug it into the arc, y2, 14 minus y1, 7 over x2, negative 2 minus x1, negative 1. Could use your calculator here, but I'm just going to do 7, and then minus a negative is the same thing as plus a positive. So that's negative 1, so the arc is negative 7. Okay, you try this one. So pause the video. Okay, f of 2 is the square root of 2 times 2 minus 4, which is 0. So we have order pair 2, 0. F of 4 is square root of 2 times 4 minus 4, which is the square root of 4, which is 2. So you should have gotten order pairs 2, 0 and 4, 2. So the arc would be, call that x1, y1 and this x2, y2. So we have 2 minus 0 over 4 minus 2 gives us 2 over 2. So the arc is 1. Okay, so that's our review. The reason we're reviewing is because now we're going to take this arc formula or slope formula and we're going to rewrite it with function notation. We're also going to change the way we talk about x2. So I'm going to draw this line here with these two points. Okay, so this line, the slope of this line represents the average rate of change for these points here. And we'll call this one x instead of x1. So the output that goes with that x, whatever this function is, the output is f of x. And then instead of calling this x2, what we're going to do is rename it using this distance. We're going to call the distance between these two x coordinates h. Okay, so that means that this second x coordinate is x plus h. And so then that output would be f of x plus h. So now to translate the arc formula using these this notation, this is our second y coordinate. So that's f of x plus h minus our first y coordinate, which would be f of x, over our x2, which is renamed x plus h, and then our x1, which is x. So if we do some simplifying here, we get f of x plus h minus f of x, divided by, see this x plus h minus x, these x's cancel, and that's just h. And so remember, this is the difference quotient. You have to have it memorized. And remember, h is the distance between the two x coordinates. Okay, so here is how you find the difference quotient given a function. I've broken it down into three steps based off of this formula that you have memorized. The difference quotient is f of x plus h minus f of x. So you would have to find f of x plus h first. Okay, so we're going to do that. So f of x plus h, function notation, that's your input. So that's going to go in place of everywhere you see an x. Those x's are going to disappear because they're really not x's, they're inputs. That's where you put stuff. So finding f of x plus h means I'm going to have two parentheses x plus h quantity squared minus three parentheses x plus h plus two. And there's that binomial squared that I told you were going to see a lot. You see it just about every lesson from here on out. And so it's a really good idea to know the shortcut squaring a binomial. We call it square double square. And you have to do it first because of PEMDAS. We have to do the exponents first. So x plus h quantity squared. You can't distribute the exponent inside. That's wrong. Remember, that means x plus h times x plus h. And you can do it the long way. You can FOIL it out. That's x squared plus xh plus hx plus h squared. But these two are really the same thing. They're like terms. So you add them together, you get 2xh. And so that's where I get my square double square. So you can save a little time if you remember square double square. Write the 2 down and then square the x, that's x squared. Multiply those two together, that's xh, and double it, so that becomes 2xh, and then square the h. See, and you get what you got over here the long way. Now we're going to distribute the minus 3 to both terms. That's a very common error. Nobody ever misses this minus 3x, but oh, how many times people have not distributed that negative to the second term. Okay, now we're going to distribute the 2, so that's 2x squared plus 4xh plus 2h squared. We have our minus 3x minus 3h plus 2. Now take a look and see if you can find like terms. Can you find any like terms? Nope. And you won't. When you do this x plus h substituting into this quadratic, you're going to always get this long series of not like terms. Okay, so the next step, let's look at the difference quotient. We found f of x plus h. The next step would we have to subtract f of x. Well, where's f of x? Well, f of x is simply this original function. So step 2, I'm put right here. So here's f of x plus h, and we need to subtract f of x. Okay, well, here's what I do. Subtraction is the same as adding the opposite. Okay, subtraction is the same as adding the opposite. So what I do is I just take these three terms here and write the opposite of them down. It's kind of like I'm distributing the negative. So 2x squared is negative 2x squared. Negative 3x is positive 3x. And 2 is negative 2. So now instead of having to remember to subtract and remember the rules for subtraction, I have just changed it to adding the opposite. So now I can just add because I've already dealt with the negative. So that's gone because they're opposites. We have 4xh plus 2h squared. That's gone. Minus 3h. That's gone. Notice that every term in the f of x function got canceled out. That will happen every time as well when you have a quadratic. All right, so we've done this. We found f of x plus h, and then we just subtracted f of x by adding the opposite of f of x. So then the last step is you have to divide everything by h. So if we divide everything by h, it looks like this. You can do this two ways. You can distribute that h into all three, or some people like to factor out the common h. So if we pull the h out, we're left with 4x plus 2h minus 3, all divided by h. And factoring is your friend. So now that you have multiplication here and you have division here, h divided by h, you can just divide that out to 1, and your difference quotient is 4x plus 2h minus 3. The other way, as I said, you could just have to remember to divide that h out 3 times. So 4x h divided by h is 4x, 2h squared divided by h is 2h, and minus 3h divided by h is minus 3, and you get your difference quotient. Alright, let's try another one. This time we have a negative w squared, and I would highly recommend you just put the negative 1 in there. And it says construct and simplify the difference quotient. Well, the difference quotient is f of x plus h minus f of x over h. And you can use that to help you remember the steps. So step 1 is to find f of x plus h. Also, I changed the letters on you. And sometimes people don't like that. So I don't want you, people ask me, can I change that to f and x? If you understand what all this stuff means, then you should be able to transition. So this f is the name of the function. What's the name of the function here? G. This x is my input. What's my input here? W. This h stands for distance from between the x coordinates. That won't change. So g of x plus w plus h minus g of w over h is the difference quotient for this problem. So don't change it, just use the letters that we give you. It helps to help you understand. Alright, so step 1, let's find g of w plus h. So that would be negative 1 parentheses w plus h quantity squared, because that w isn't really w, that's the input. This is where we put stuff. What are we putting in? W plus h. Minus 4. Again, you have to put w plus h in place of that w, plus 2. So if you have two w's or two x's, you have to put your input in both of those places. All right, let's use square double square this time. So negative 1, and then when I square double square this, I'm going to get a trinomial. Square the w, that's w squared. Multiply these two together, that's wh, but you'll have two of them. You double it, and then you square the h. Let's go ahead and distribute the negative 4, and then we have plus 2. Now we'll distribute the negative 1, the understood negative 1 that I wrote out, it really helps. So that's negative 1 w squared minus 2 wh minus 1 h squared minus 4 w minus 4 h plus 2. So step 1 is done. Step 2, minus g of w. Minus g of w is the same as adding the opposite of the g of w terms. So the opposite of negative 1 w squared is positive w squared. The opposite of negative 4 w is positive 4 w. The opposite of 2 is negative 2. They cancel, they cancel, they cancel. Not a coincidence. That will happen every time. You're left with negative 2wh minus 1h squared minus 4h. Step 2 is done. Step 3, divide by h. You can do that one of two ways. You can factor out the h from the numerator. So that's h parentheses negative 2w minus 1h minus 4 divided by h, and then h divided by h is 1. So that's your difference quotient right there. Okay, let's look at another one. Now that we've done two quadratics, sometimes when we go back down to a linear function, it causes people to have trouble. So I want to do one of those. And again, I'm deliberately changing the function names so you can work on understanding function notation. So the difference quotient for this one will be, the name of the function is a g function. The input is a. So g of a plus h, remember that distance from a, minus g of a over h. So don't skip out on learning that. That's a good practice. Okay, so step one, find g of a of h. So we only have this input here, so that's going to be 5 minus 7 eighths times a plus h. Okay, and then a lot of people just get scared of the fractions. Do the algebra and let the calculator handle the fractions. But really, you don't have to worry right now because we're just multiplying, right? You can't add those together or subtract those. You have to multiply first. So we need to distribute the negative 7 eighths into a and h. And multiplying a fraction times a variable is not difficult. It's just minus 7 eighths h minus 7 eighths a h. That is the tricky part. Will you remember to distribute the negative? That's what I worry about. Okay, and so you're done. And that messes with people because they don't have a square to square double square. It's because it's just a linear. So this is going to be easier. All right, we're ready to move to step two. Step two is subtract g of a. So this is g of a plus h. Let's subtract g of a. It's the same thing, plus a negative. So the opposite of 5 is negative 5. And the opposite of negative 7 eighths a is positive 7 eighths a. They cancel, not a coincidence. And you're left with negative 7 eighths h. Okay, the last step, C, it says find the difference quotient. This is the last step, divide by h. And so you just divide that by h and you get negative 7 eighths. So if it's a linear, it's going to be a lot easier. The difference quotient is a slope, or it's the average rate of change, and this is a line, and the slope of a line is constant. So that's why your difference quotient is just a constant negative 7 eighths, as opposed to this difference quotient, the slope is going to change depending on the x coordinate you put in here and the distance from that x coordinate you put in there. So we got a quadratic, we have a linear example, and there's several in the lab manual for you to try.